Now I had the time of my life.
Publisher of The Three Tomatoes. I'm also known as the Head Tomato. Great pleasure to introduce my really dear friend, the one and only hostess with the mostest, Randie Levine-Miller.
Know people like show people. They smile when they are low.
And the first Tomatoes Got Talent winner is Karen Nessa! Welcome all of you to our second Tomatoes Got Talent show.
Some people can get a thrill knitting sweaters and sitting still. That's okay for some people who don't know they're alive. And our grand prize winner is Susan Berry.
Welcome to Tomatoes Got Talent.
It's such an exciting night, and it's great to be here at the Triad with so many friends. Things look swell, things look great. Gonna have the whole world on a plate.
Winner of the 6th annual Tomatoes Got Talent show is Christina Cotter!
The world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just to live up.
I had the time of my life. I never felt this way before. Yes, I swear it's so true.
I really have had the time of my life doing this show for the last 10 years. And I just can't thank you all enough for being here tonight. What an incredible crowd we have. People up in the balcony, the rafters. Thank you for your patience with getting seated tonight. We just couldn't be happier and more thrilled to share this evening with everyone, which is going to be so special. So, for the past 10 years, I can't believe we've been doing this show for 10 years, Tomatoes Got Talent has been one of our signature events of the Three Tomatoes, and it has really expressed everything that the Three Tomatoes is about, celebrating women as we grow older, making sure that there is no way in hell that we are invisible or irrelevant, and also the theme of you are never ever too old to live your dreams. And if anything has shown that, it has been everyone has ever come up and performed on the stage for the last 10 years. And I thank you all for being here. And I know there's some of you, you've been to every single one of these shows. So we thank you. You know, not just the performers who come on the stage. So when Randie and I had this idea, it was like 11 years ago. There is no way. We just had this idea, and I'm like, let's just see what happens, you know, but, you know, maybe no one will come and audition, and how will that work out? And there's just no way we could have imagined what this has grown into and how special it has become to us, but we've really formed this incredible community of women, because over the last 10 years, we have had 96 women perform on this stage in Tomatoes Got Talent. And they have really become a family, and everyone here at the Triad has become family to us. So it just, you know, things take on a life of their own, and they grow into things in unexpected ways. And this has just been really one of those amazing things. So the women who have entertained us, they've inspired us. For many of them, this show has given them a push to actually get back into show business, because many of them have started and segued to other careers. For others, it's given the interest to actually start a career in entertainment. And we're so proud of so many of them who have gone on. They're doing their own cabaret shows. They've been MAC winners. It's just been an extraordinary and really beautiful thing to see and watch. So when I think back over the last 10 years, I think I loved every show and every time these women got up here. But to me, the most exciting part of this show, of putting together the show, was always the auditions, because we never knew who was going to show up. We would put out the calls, and it was just extraordinary talent. I mean, the 96 people who've been in the shows are only a small part of the talent that is out there, and that to me was so extraordinary to see. But there would always be those people who would come on the stage in the audition, and they would start out, and you know how when you hear something special and the hair kind of stands up on your arm? Every one of the women here tonight that you're going to hear, that they were one of those women. It was like, wow, not only are they going to be in the show, but they are probably going to win this show. So to me, that was just one of the things I will always remember. So it is definitely a bittersweet night tonight as we end our 10-year run. But never say never, that's all I'll say. So many people have said, why are you ending? You can't do it. So we'll see. But right now it just seemed like the perfect time to do it and to do the show presenting all of our past Tomatoes Got Talent winners. So I have so many people to thank, but briefly I want to say, obviously the Triad, this has been our home for 10 years. Peter Martin, Gene Castle, Michael Dunn, Ben, TP, everybody has been such a delight and a pleasure. They have made it so easy to work here, and we just love that. I want to thank Mary Ann Lapinto, who's been our photographer for 10 years, Magda Katz, our video person, Laura Fever, our stage manager, and before that we had Faye Menken Schneider, who was our stage manager for the first few years, Beckley, Betsy Ann Fayella, who did our PR, and we need a huge round of applause for Paul Shamlin, who's been our musical director. I think every year but one, right? I think we've done them all. So Paul, amazing job. And he and Randie, not only, you know, when people are, we're preparing people for this show, and Randie always does the rehearsals at her home, and Paul and Randie are such great mentors to everyone and have really helped and supported them all. So they really deserve a lot of credit for that. So, and I want to thank all of our supporters here. I mean, people have been here every year. Jane Goldman, Ann Akers, Judy Stewart, Judy Davis. So many of you who have come out and supported this over the years. We love you. We thank you for that. So now I want to introduce you to our judges. We have three amazing judges, and it really is old home week because they've all judged before. In fact, two of them were our very first judges. First of all, I want to introduce our Long Island girl, because I live on Long Island, Margaret Cullen. She is a TV, film, and theater actor. Now, some of you know her from the soap opera. We do have to go back a little more, because people tell you, The Edge of Night and As the World Turns, her major roles there. So she has been in so many TV series and on Broadway. She's been in Now and Again. She's the mother on Gossip Girl. She also has a theme with the White House, because she was in Independence Day, the film. She was the communications director for the president. She won a SAG Award for her role on Veep, and she also played Jackie Kennedy on Broadway in Jackie. So she's, I don't know, there may be something else in the future with the White House. White House too. And these days you can see her on Chicago Med and so many things as her fabulous career continues. And then we have the absolutely beautiful Alice Fennell.
Yeah.
Alice is an Emmy and producer and writer. She's also the co-director of the Mabel Mercer Foundation, which produces the cabaret convention every year. It's happening this month, in just a couple of weeks, which is always a fabulous evening of keeping cabaret alive for everyone. Alice is also the co-author of a book that I was actually, through our publishing arm, very honored to publish, called Consilitus, and it's a very funny book of puns, and it's a delightful book.
Punsalas,
try to pronounce it. And both, as I said, both Margaret and Alice were our first judges, along with Beth Fowler, who couldn't be here tonight. But I think you were our judges for the first 3 years. And then also returning as a judge tonight is the fabulous Gretchen Cryer. She's a brilliant American playwright, along with Nancy Ford. She created several successful stage musicals, including Shelter, I'm Getting My Act Together, and Taking It on the Road, and The Last Sweet Days of Isaac. And this, I really love this, because I have a granddaughter, and she and her granddaughter, Gracie Hyland, right now are writing a new musical together called House on Fire. How cool is that? I love that. So, we love that. So now, for the 10th time, I get to announce, to get this party started, is my dear friend and producer, co-producer of tonight's show and host of tonight's event, Randie Levine-Miller. Randie is known as the hostess with the mostest. You know, she started out also wanting to be a performer, like many people tonight, segued into other roles. She had a very successful career in PR before coming back to her roots of hosting and music and cabaret, and she has performed for so many groups and organizations for benefits, the Actors Temple, the Friars Club, you name it. And also these days, I'm proud to say, she's also our Broadway babe at the Three Tomatoes, because she does a great column on finding all these incredible streaming shows on YouTube that we all can see. So, for the 10th time, I get to introduce my great friend, Randie Levine-Miller.
How are you going to make that dream come true? And
many of us have turned our dreams into realities. When the sky is a bright canary yellow, I forget every cloud I've ever seen. So they call me a cockeyed optimist. It's the tour and incurably green. I have heard people rant and rave and bellow that we're dumb and we might as well be dead. I'm only a cockeyed optimist. And I can't get it into my head. I hear the human race is falling on its face and hasn't very far to go. I don't want to believe that, but every whippoorwill is selling me a pill and telling me it just ain't so. I can say life is just a bowl of Jell-O and appear more intelligent than smart. But I'm stuck like a dope with this thing called hope, and I can't get it into my heart. Not this heart. Yeah, I gotta have heart. Oh, yeah, maybe it's hard. When the odds are saying you'll never win, that's when the grin should start. There's nothing to it but to do it. You gotta have heart. Miles and miles and miles apart. Oh, it's fine to be a genius, of course, but keep that old horse before the cart. First, you gotta have heart. I could say life is just a bowl of Jell-O and appear more intelligent than smart. But I'm stuck like a dope with this thing called hope, and I can't get it into my heart. Not this heart. Not this heart. Am I doing this right, Cheryl? Okay, good. Okay, I'm trying to follow the running order. By the way, we don't do a run through, so we are like by the seat of our pants doing the show tonight. They rehearse the songs at my place. We do no run through, and then we pray that we don't make total jerks of ourselves. So, okay. So, two of our people, we're going to show you some really great film footage of our first winner, Karen Nason, and our second winner, Susan Vardy, who could not be here with us tonight. Karen is bigger than life. She just blew us out of the water, and I mean, she just I don't know, our Spanx practically fell off because she was just incredible. And she's an entrepreneur. She even ran for mayor of one of the New Jersey, Hoboken. She didn't win. But she wins at everything else, and she was the plant lady to the star. She had a plant business, and now she has a jazz club in Maine. Unfortunately, she's stuck in Florida, which is why she's not here. Okay, that's number one. And then immediately following her is Susan Vardy, who won our second Tomatoes Got Talent. And Susan is a PhD psychologist. She teaches musical theater in New Jersey. She does some directing. But she was a pro on the road doing Hello Dolly, directed by Leroy Reams, who we love. And she was about to come into New York, but somewhere on the road, she met this guy. She married him. They married many, 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 many years. He's a gynecologist.
Whoa.
And he's a doll. Michael is a doll. Anyway, and she's quite fabulous.
I live inside myself, I live alone, and it feels safe, it feels like home to me. Now suddenly I'm feeling like I don't belong. I never thought I'd meet somebody else as strong as me. I can't give in, he's much too close. I could get lost in him and find a part of me that I don't care to know. A fragile little girl that I lost years ago. Step back, love. I'm on my own. You're only getting in the way. Leave my heart alone. I never needed you before I met you. Stand back, love. Don't let me fall. I know what he can do to me. And if you stay away from me and let this heart go free to take me through. 'Cause it takes everything I have to make my dreams come true. And to make my dreams come true, it can't be you, love, I'm dreaming of. So stand back, stand back, stand back, love. I'm on my own, you're only getting in the way. Leave my heart alone. I never needed you before I met you. Stand back, love. Don't let me fall. I know what he can do to me. And if you take off, stay away from me and let this heart go. Stand back.
Every vow I'm keeping out of mischief.
She's a scientist. They have an organization called Prostate Action Inc. And they are people that are changing the world. So she is going to come up and sing Ken, my friend Ken Waston's favorite song that, and he produced the original Grease. And when he says somebody is talented, they are very talented because he discovered John Travolta, Richard Gere, who else? Oh, Mary Lou Hanna when she was in college, yeah. Everybody. So, who? Oh, Richard Gere, everybody. Okay, and anyway, so the point is, he just loves the way she does this song. And I know that Ken is never gone. So, and also the other thing is the late Irvin Drake, composer of What Makes Sammy Run, there's also The Morning Heartache, and he was a very good singer, called Alice New York's favorite singing endocrinologist.
Really?
But this is what he said, exactly. He said, "What a pleasure to listen to a doctor who knows how to treat a lyric as well as she treats a patient." Alice Levine.
So I'm the first of the contestants, and I like my audiences to feel comfortable. So Randie told you a lot about me, but I don't want you to be wondering about anything. And I know you're looking at me and you're thinking, her coloring, her way of speaking, and that name, that exotic name, Alice Levine. Is she French? Is she Nordic? And no, I want to tell you this, I want you to be comfortable. I'm Jewish, and I'm from Brooklyn. Told you, I do have another job, a day job, and I love it. I love it, and medicine can be just as glamorous as show business. I mean, you haven't lived until you've been fighting with an insurance company to try and get prior authorization. Seriously. But I do love my day job. However, this was what I wanted to do long ago, and you know, look around, don't tell my colleagues and my patients, but look at this, and all of this, I mean, duh. The butcher, the
baker, the grocer, the clerk are secretly unhappy men because the butcher, the baker, the grocer, the clerk, the endocrinologist get paid for what they do, but no applause. They gladly bid their dreary jobs goodbye for anything theatrical and wine. There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere can you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low, even with a turkey that you know will fold. You may be stranded out in the cold, still you wouldn't trade it for a sack of gold. Let's go on with the show. The costumes, the scenery, the makeup, the props, the audience that lifts you when you're down. The headaches, the heartaches, the backaches, the flops, the sheriff who escorts you out of town. The opening when your heart beats like a drum. The closing when the customers won't come. There's no business like show business, like no business I know. You get word before the show has started that your favorite uncle died at dawn. Top of that, your ma and pa have parted. You're brokenhearted, but you go on. There's no people like show people. They don't run out of dough. Angels come from everywhere with lots of jack. And when you lose it, there's no attack. Where can you get money that you don't give back? Let's go. Cowboys, the wrestlers, the tumblers, the clowns, the roustabouts who move the show at dawn. The music, the people, the spotlight, the towns, your baggage with the labels pasted on. The sawdust and the horses and the smell. The towel you've taken from the last hotel. There's no business like show business, like no business I know. Traveling through the country will be thrilling, standing out in front on opening night, smiling as you watch a theater filling. And there's your filling. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you opened and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they've hung a star. Let's go.
She always loved doing plays in high school, but she was always cast as an old broad from the time she was 16. She was the best 16-year-old Aunt Ella, before high school ever saw. So, but now, and she doesn't look it, she looks great. I'm very shallow, she looks great. Okay, so, but now she's a grandma of three. She is a ripening, I can't say overripe tomato, because there are some of us that really are. She's ripening, okay. So it's time for Leslie to get back on stage for her own act two. Please welcome Leslie, not Leslie Ann Warren, she's much older than her, but Leslie Warren.
Thank you, Randy. One of my favorite things about being a tomato is getting to meet and getting to know so many wonderful women. Now, we come downstairs and we entertain you, but upstairs in the green room, we're having a blast, let me tell you. When I won a couple years ago, it gave me a boost in my confidence and reminded me that I'm a performer. Thank you. And most of the women here in the show tonight, at some point in our lives, life came along, and we started using our other talents to raise a family, or start a business, or manage an office, or just pay the bills. But tonight, with Paul's help, I'm going to come around from behind that desk. And we're gonna show you what we got. A five, six, a five, six, seven, eight. The only way is up, and I'll be up like a rosebud high on a vine. Don't thumb your nose, but take a tip from mine. I'm a little bit short of the elbow room, so let me get me some. And look out, world, here I come. Paul!
Judge Margaret Colin was in the show, and this is what's so interesting. She stopped the show every time she came on stage, but she never sang. Her performance was so extraordinary that she just wowed the audience, and she won an award for this too. She, to me, is one of the finest actresses of her generation. I've seen her do a lot of things on Broadway. But I had to share that because it was Rodgers and Hammerstein, and it was one of the most memorable moments in the American theater. So, Robin Ryan, what happened to Gardner? Robin Ryan Gardner. Okay. I think she chopped off the last name. She must have chopped off the last husband. I don't know. But she won Tomatoes Got Talent in 2021. She's a real estate broker now and has been for 18 years. But she came to New York for a career on Broadway. And 8 months out of college, she was cast in the road company of a chorus line, bus and truck, then she was with the international company, and then she was on Broadway performing, closing performances at the, I guess it was the Schubert Theater in 1990. And she toured, she's done a lot of stuff, but she toured opposite Donny Osmond and Joseph in the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. She's launched her one-woman show, been there, done that, now what? I mean, that's a really good title. I like that. Okay. And she's performed it in New York and around the country. And she's going to sing the song she sang that won her the Tomatoes Got Talent Award. Yes. So please welcome Robin Lyon, or yes. Robin Lyon Gardner.
I'm Robin Lyon
Gardner.
yes, thank you, Randie. I came here in 1981 to be on Broadway. 8 months out of college, I started living my dream and went on to do other shows for about 20 years on Broadway. And I was sent out for this one show many, many times. And I would get so excited every time I'd get an audition for the role of Grisabella in Cats. And I was so, that was the role I was actually meant to play. I was a big Broadway belter and I was very excited. Well, I auditioned 17 times and never got it. I know, very sad. But fast forward, when it was revived a few years ago, I thought, well, I really am the old cat now, and I could really play this role now. And then they gave it to a 30-year-old. So I never got to play the role, and I'm here tonight to sing my rendition of Memory. So I just need one second to prepare. Midnight, I wake up and remember that I left the door open with the groceries outside. Where the hell did I put my keys? Oh, look, here they are, underneath the TV guide. Memory, what became of the short term? I remember the old days. I was sharper back then. If I eat fish and do the crossword every day, will the brain cells grow again? I could swear I put those tickets right here in my wallet. Now I'm late. I thought the show starts at 8. I wrote that. Where's that ginkgo biloba that I picked up today? Oh, I left it at Whole Foods. What the heck is that guy's name? He sings with me in the choir. City Field parking lot. what was the question?
Another powerhouse. They're all powerhouses. Okay. Kelly McGuire loves to perform. She's a longtime resident of New York, and she's originally from Ohio. She's a carnival girl. I mean, she doesn't look like a carnival girl, but she's a carnival girl. And she grew up at carnivals, and she can put up and take down a Ferris wheel. This is the truth. Anyway, she has, this is what she's got in her life. Besides a job, and she's also working over at that wonderful theater on 45th Street, the ALM, it's Al Tapper, wait a minute, so
AMT.
AMT, Al, I forgot his middle name, and okay, I interviewed him for the Friars Club. He's a powerhouse too, but not as powerful as you, Kelly. You are the best. So, okay, so she has a daughter, a dog, a cat, a snake, a guinea pig, and a husband. I don't know how she manages, but she does. Anyway, please welcome Kelly McGuire.
Thank you. I grew up in a carnival until I was 19 years old. I had a balloon dart game and a coke toss game that my family ran. And one of the things about winning on Tomatoes Got Talent is that it gave me the confidence to put together a one-woman show about my years in the carnival. Yay. So I performed it this past year, and I'm going to be, you know, working on it and continue with it. But it's called Invisible Fish, because my dad would set up a big, large table with an elaborate sign said Invisible Fish $1, put a big fish bowl of water, and people would come up and buy a baggie of water. We never had anybody come back. So I named my show Invisible Fish. So in the carnival, there are a lot of colorful people. And one of them just happened to be a woman by the name of Rosie. She had her fingers in a lot of different pies, let me tell you that. But Rosie had one little problem. Booze! Mama told me, booze will keep you happy till you're 6 feet underground. And though I've toasted Mom in heaven since I was 6 or 7, my happiness has never come to pass. When I'm feeling hot to trot, Ma's advice goes down real nice, but it just don't hit the spot. Well, there's one thing they can't sell me. The bitch forgot to tell me. A man doesn't come in a glass. Whiskers wrapped around a cigar. Pour me a face black with bristle and watch me with my whistle. Pour me a man. What good is scotch, whether it's with or without the old twist? Scotch ain't got a watch around its hairy left wrist. Pour me a bulging bicep bastard and watch me get plastered. It's thicker. What good is beer? I've had enough to fill Niagara Falls. But beer's ain't got 2 ears, 2 eyes, 2 arms, 2 legs under a pair of overalls. Pour me a mug with a head on top, and I'll chug him drop by drop and make him last as long as I can.
to again thank my musical director of 26 years, and we're still getting along. Well, that's because we don't see each other a lot during the year. That's the answer. But he's great. So everybody, Paul Chandler. So next up, oh, she is amazing. Okay, Evangeline Johns says it wasn't until she turned 80 when making her debut with Tomatoes Got Talent that she gave voice to her recently discovered inner blues singer. And she worked at CBS in research for years. I mean, she had a really good day job. And anyway, she decided to take the leap to the cabaret stage, and she's been doing a lot of shows with her daughter, Ariana, who's here tonight, and they're all delightful. And I have to say, the show is called Banjari, I'm sorry. And they do it at Don't Tell Mama and other venues ever since, and it's like a whole new career. The thing is, if you wake up with a purpose, you can live your dream, you can turn it into reality at any age. And Banshee's done that, and she's really quite extraordinary. Please welcome Evangeline Johns.
I'd like to give my deepest thanks to Randy and Cheryl, and Paul, and everyone who is connected with the TGT group for giving a whole lot of us ladies the chance to get up here and sing on the Triad stage, or do stand-up, whatever some of them do. And not only that, but it has opened the doors to other opportunities and given us the courage to go out and spread ourselves around. And yes, I did discover my little inner blues voice when I was in my eighth decade, so never too late. And tonight I'm going to sing Bessie Smith, God love her, but no, this is a Billie Holiday number.
Yes.
And yeah, she wrote it in 1939, I remember it well. And it's a song that tells a tale that has made many a woman sing the blues since forever. Hit it, Paul.
Stay home every day.
like the faucet. It turns off and on. Yeah, 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 la, 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 la. It's like a faucet. It turns off and on. Just when you think it's on, baby.
Everybody know how honored she feels to have been resident of Tomato World. She's grateful for the friendship she has made. She says that it's been a real confidence builder. She plays over at Chez Josephine and at Don't Tell Mama, and she's terrific. And she quotes Ruth Gordon, an actress who received her first Academy Award at the age of 73. She says, "I can't tell you how encouraging a thing like this is." Ladies and gentlemen, Sherry Sano.
Thank you, Randie. Thank you, Cheryl, for all these years of Tomato shows. It's really become like a family, and I'm very grateful to be a part of it. Thank you so much. Now, sometimes people will ask me, "What's your favorite song?" And I usually alternate between drawing a complete blank and thinking, well, isn't that unfair to all the other songs if I pick one? That said, when the question comes up, more often than not, this is the song that comes to mind. Someday, when I'm awfully old, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. You are lovely with your smile so warm, when you stand so near, there is nothing for me but to love you just the way you look tonight. With each word, your tenderness grows, tearing my fear apart. And that laugh that wrinkles your nose touches my foolish heart. You are lovely. Never, never, never change. Keep that breathless charm, darling. Please arrange it, 'cause I love you just the way you look tonight. Just the way you look.
Several awards, and I know she works with Paul. She's a marketing coordinator in the wealth department at Neuberger Berman, and by night she continues singing in cabaret clubs. But she received the Hansen Award from the Manhattan Association of Cabaret Clubs. That's sort of like
you know, the Drama Desk, the Tony. It's an important award for her continued excellence in cabaret. She's never met a novelty song that she hasn't liked. I don't think she's ever stolen anything, though, like other people. But she she received great reviews for her tribute to Rosemary Clooney, entitled More Than You Know, and she's been featured at Lori Beachman and Don't Tell Mama, and yada, yada, yada. Please welcome Teresa Fisher.
Hi. Oh, I'm Sydney. Oh, my goodness. Sydney is the reason that I did the tomatoes. I got a little email from him, and he said, I think you ought to do this, and I'm really glad that I did. Woo-hoo! It's been wonderful meeting all these terrific people. It really has been. Now, in 1993, I left my life as a Midwest girl behind. I sold my car, I rented a U-Haul, and my cat and I drove, well, I did most of the driving, 1,200 miles from Kansas City to my fourth floor walk-up studio apartment above Danny's Chinese Laundry on the Upper East Side. Now, I started temping to learn the city, and one day, my route took me to what I knew was a magnificent New York landmark. It was a defining moment. I gave Price Chopper the axe. I got rid of Piggly Wiggly. I did not need a Safeway. I stood as those automatic doors opened and said, "Welcome, New Yorker." I was now getting my groceries at Gristini's. Gristini's. We met in Gristini's by the jello display when you first came my way. House tricks. Gristini's. We were both in Gristini's. I was looking for Wheaties. You were looking for kicks. I didn't see you at first, and it seemed as if nothing was wrong. Then our eyes exchanged grins. I might stay quite as gay as an elf.
massage therapist.
Right.
But she is, well, she's dedicating her singing career to supporting the health and well-being of children and their families due to these current times of uncertainty. Certainly true. And her co-author, David Friedman, the composer, the arranger, the astonishingly talented David Friedman, and the astonishingly talented Christina, have co-authored a book, children's book, titled We Can Be Kind, which is inspired by David's song of the same title, and it's soon to be released. It's their hope that this book will be a catalyst for turning the tide into a more kind direction. Yes, if only we could be kind. That would be just wonderful. Please welcome Christina Collins.
Thank you so much. It's so wonderful to be here on the stage again. It has been 5 years since I was on the stage, 2019. And it was such a joy, and it's just such an honor to be able to perform with these incredible women, truly. And so I have had a lot of things happen since 2019, and a couple life-altering experiences. So one, I got engaged, and I'm married, and now I'm happily married to my husband, Bill. And the second event was we lost my brother suddenly. He was 47, his name was Eric. And he was the kindest person I've ever met. And there's not a day that goes by that I don't think of him. And fast forward 5 years, my niece is expecting my brother's first grandchild, Mason Eric. And as soon as they told me that he was gonna be born, I thought to myself, I'm going to vow to create as much of a kind world that he can inherit that I can do. And I know that kindness starts with me, being kind to myself, especially when I'm feeling fear, and then extending that kindness out and creating ripple. And I want to ask you one question. Who do you love so much that you are willing to grow for? So many things we can't control, so many hurts that happen every day, so many heartaches that pierce the soul, so much pain that won't ever go away. How do we make it better? How do we make it through? What can we do when there's nothing we can do? We can be kind, we can take care of each other, we can remember that deep down inside we all need the same thing, and maybe we'll find. Does nobody want to see it? Does nobody understand? The power to heal is right here in our hand. We can be kind. We can take care of each other. We can remember that deep down inside we all need the same thing.
enough to sing a song. We must walk the walk about it, you and I, do or die. We've got to try and get alive. We can be kind. We can take care.
Showstopper had to think about Kathy Waters. She's the mother of Kamal. She's a member of various bands, performing all genres of music, including pop, rhythm and blues, reggae, and she's, since winning TGT, she's released several singles, including her latest, Superwoman, which she is, and it's all available on streaming platforms. She's also recorded several gospel songs with her twin sister, Catherine. And I never really understood. She's Kathy and her sister is Catherine. And I get very confused because I think I'm Facebook friends with both of them. Maybe she can explain it. I really, it's like one is with a C, one is with a K. I don't know how your parents differentiated. And you're twins. You're not fraternal, but you're probably identical twins. Okay. I don't know. You could explain all that tonight. I would like to know. Okay. So today she's going to be performing a song from Tina, the musical. So fasten your seatbelts. Here comes Kathy Waters.
Thank you. Thank you, Cheryl. Welcome, everybody.
Hi.
All right. It's Catherine and Kathleen. On fire, you come to me wild and wired. Oh, you come to me, give me everything I need. Give me a lifetime of promises and a world of dreams. Speak a language of love like you know what it means.
Stop!
judging. I think Ronnie is going to take them out, and my partner here in crime, Cheryl Benton, is going to come up for the next segment of this wonderful show. Oh, you're here. I know you're here.
I'm here. So I just, before we do that, I just want to say, first of all, I hope you've seen this. All have enjoyed this amazing evening, as much as I have. And Randy, I just want to say, we have to give ourselves kudos. We created one hell of an event. Thank you. Yes, so anyway, and I'm going to have you stay up here with me while I introduce the next thing, because I think if you have seen tonight, we have created, we didn't know what this was going to be, it just happened, but we created this incredible community of incredibly talented women who came up here and performed their hearts out, whether they auditioned and they didn't get into the finals or they did and whatnot. So one of the people who was so special to both of us performed on the stage in 2018. She was one of our finalists and performed last year. She was such a bright light. She was one of Randy's pickups, actually. Randy picks up people.
Always.
She would find this talent. That was one of the great things about all of our auditions, because Randy would always find these people over the years. And Ro was one of those people who just so touched her heart. She stepped on the stage. She was a psychologist. She was one of those bright lights. I truly believe that angels walk on earth, and Ro was one of those angels that walked on earth. And we are so honored to have her husband, Carl Sarris. Carl, stand up so we can all see you. You had such a great love story. It was your soulmate. It was a wonderful love story. And she performed in our last show. And so sadly, last July, after a long battle with cancer, Ro passed away. And she will always remain in our hearts. She was a bright light. She lit up every room that she walked into. She was kind, generous, and just gave back to everyone. And you're about to see this in our tribute. Yes.
I just have to add, what was amazing also about Ro, she knew that time was getting shorter for her, and she entered the Miss Senior America New Jersey contest. She booked herself into every venue in New Jersey. They live in New Jersey. Is this correct, Carl? And she was a contagion of kindness and enthusiasm and passion. She had a passion for music. She had a passion for Carl. She had a passion for everything. And I cannot remember feeling more touched by a performance or performer as a human being. I bet she was great with her patients too. But we loved her. And she always had a smile on her face, a spring to her walk. And she just, as Cheryl said, she lit up the stage. And honestly, she lit up my life and many others. So
this is our tribute to Ro. Thank you, Carl. Our heart goes out to you. Thank you for being here tonight.
Time to say goodbye.
Coley, who we love. She is terrific. She's a great person and recently married to Carl, is it Sari? Sari. I know he's not Sari. He's definitely Sari. And they are a great couple. Ro has had a lot of challenges in life, and she's back and better than ever. She's a psychologist, and she loves singing and performing, whether it's a Don't Tell Mama, or at various senior facilities in South Jersey where she currently resides with her really wonderful husband. We should all be so lucky, Olivai. Okay. She's thrilled to be back on the Triad stage performing with her sister, Tomatoes. Please welcome my friend and somebody that we all love, Ro Piccoli. Hey, friends. It's so good to be here. So, in June of this year, I was in the Miss New Jersey Senior America pageant. Yeah, I was. I lost. No, but there was no losers, you know. Well, I actually did come in second runner-up. That's presentable, right? That's not bad. But, you know, the crown eluded me. But I think I know why. If there's a wrong way to say it, a wrong way to play it, nobody does it like me. If there's a wrong way to do it, a right way to screw it up, nobody does it like me. I've got a big, loud mouth. I'm always talking much too free. If you go for tact and manners, better stay away from me. If there's a wrong way to keep it cool, the right way to be a fool, nobody does it like me. I hear a love song or ballad, I toss like a salad. Nobody tosses like me. And when my evening gets tougher, I just take two Bufferin and I drink a hot cup of tea. Nobody does it. Nobody does it like me. Nobody does it like me.
Thank you, Carl. We all love Tro, so she's here with us tonight. So now, while we're waiting for the judges to come out to tell us who the Tomatoes super talent star is, Randy's gonna do another number, right?
Yes, I decided that since it's the last show, I may as well book myself as the guest singer. And I just want to say, may Ro's memory be for a blessing. My heart be still. Okay, Paul.
Memories like the corners of my mind. Misty watercolored memories of the way you were. Scattered pictures of the smiles we left behind. Smiles we gave to one another of the way we were. It all be so simple then, or has time rewritten every line? If we had the chance to do it all again, tell me, could we? Would we? Memories may be beautiful and yet what's too painful to remember? We sometimes choose to forget. So it's the laughter we will remember. Whenever we remember the way we were. Way we were.
And so many of us now are, well, we have our memories, we have our yesterdays, we have today, and please God,
We should all have better and blessing filled tomorrows. And we're at a crossroads, and I keep losing my earrings.
Oh, what the hell?
Where am I going and what will I find? What's in this grab bag that I call my mind? What am I doing alone on the shelf? Ain't it a shame? No one's to blame but myself. Which way is clear? When you've lost your way, year after year, do I keep falling in love for just the kick of it, staggering through the thin and thick of it, hating each old and tired trick of it? Know what I am? I'm good and sick of it. Where am I going? No matter where I run, I meet myself there. Looking inside me, what do I see? Anger and hope and doubt, what am I all about? And where am I going? Why do I care? Where am I going? You tell me. Tell me. Thank you all so much. Thank you. I think the judges are coming back, and Ronnie is going to come up on stage. And
okay. All right, we need to bring up all of our fabulous performers tonight who were just amazing onto the stage.
Come on, everybody.
Everyone.
I just want to touch upon something that my mom and Randie didn't mention. So over these past 10 years, when all these ladies, I'm sorry, I don't want to block you, Alice, when everyone auditioned and is, you know, outside of the 96 people who've made it, there have literally have been hundreds and hundreds of people who have auditioned over these 10 years. And I have MS, and the audition fee that everybody pays to get in is a donation to the MS Society. So over these 10 years, thank you, we've raised upwards of about $10,000. Pretty amazing. Go to the MS Society, go help find a cure. Obviously, it's near and dear to my heart, but I have to say thank you for that. I'm out of breath, I don't know why. Walking up the stairs. Because it's exciting, it's the last year that we're doing it. You guys are amazing. Thank you to our judges. I know they had a pretty tough time, as they do every single year. So,
best show ever.
With that, best show ever. Loves and laughs, and again, it's for great causes. As these women have said, they've all become family, and you know, and then the benefit of going to help find a cure for MS is really very near and dear. Thank you. So, okay, our first winner is Leslie Warren! Our next, Kelly McGuire!
Kelly,
come on up, come on up, come on up, ladies! Sherry Sano! Christina Connors. Happy one.
at the last minute. She's always a winner in our book, as is Karen Nason and Susan Vardy, our first and second winners of Tomatoes Got Talent. Everybody here is a winner. Take a bow. Thank you very much for being with us.
We're going to do the best of times, but being that our times suck is a terrible song to sing at this particular time. It's a great song. So we're going to sing, and I'm sure that you all know this song because I did it before, and it's a standard. So let's all sing hard because we have to have hope and we have to have great heart. And thank you all for coming. You are fabulous. All the bells and bowls, there is a
yeah.